So hello guys, welcome to my YouTube channel Stammerer Krishnendu. So this is an interview series, and today we will interview of one of my relative, very close relative. And the best thing about is that he is also stammerer, and he is obviously very experienced in IT sector industry. So we will just take some tips and also what he did to overcome his stammering. So my name is Karen. So my name is Krishnendu Gorai. So what's your name, please?
My name is Dilip Kumar Gorai.
So please tell me something about yourself.
Myself Dilip Kumar Gorai, and I'm working in IIT industry, and I'm having more than 12 to 13 years of experience, and I'm also a stammerer.
Okay. So means, since you are very much experienced in the IT industry, so means obviously you are a stammerer, so you had many experiences due to stammering, many bad experiences, or maybe it may be good experiences. So please tell me something about your experiences and due to stammering, and what stammering has affected in your life and how you have overcome in your stammering. Because as we know that while working in a private company, it's very important to have a very nice communication skill. So being a stammerer, how it is possible to work in so much big industries?
Okay, I'm sharing my experience, not in the working field. I'm sharing my experience till my childhood. When I was in school, I was a stammerer, so I faced a lot of things. Suppose while there was a bhaiwa, and I know the answer, but I was not able to answer it. Then obviously I used to get a less mark. And due to this also, I used to study in a boys hostel. So due to stammering also, I was too much scared to talk to any girls, because I was feeling shy that how they are going to react with me, and how they are behaving with me, or might be they'll make a fun of me. So I was a lot of bad experience, and due to this, I used to keep myself aside from everyone, in front of my friends, far away from my teachers and all. Then once I was in college, in engineering college, there also the same thing I faced. I was not able to talk to the girls. There are a lot of rankings are going on, or seniors are used to ask me to go and ask something, take biodata, or you talk to these girls and all. But I was not able to talk to the girls, because as one, I was a stammerer, one thing, and I was too, plus I was a very shy guy. And I was just shy because of stammering.
Okay.
It's not like that I was born shy. But due to stammering issues, I became a shy guy. So I was not able to talk to anyone freely. And then in bhaiwa also, I used to get a less mark. And one more important thing that I faced, and I overcome this. Then a little bit I thought, suppose our teacher used to ask me one question. I know the answer, but I was not able to answer it, because few words I was not able to utter properly. So suppose I'm giving you example. Suppose that my answer is I was in an A-star hotel. I know the answer. The answer will be this, but was not able to speak properly due to this stammering. So then I thought, how come I overcome this? Then I thought, no, I have to tell this point, but I have to talk in a reverse way. That means, okay, this hotel is too good, I was there, facilities are there. Not in a directly I used to stay in a star hotel. So in the reverse way, might be it will take time, or might be your answer will be not clear, but it's not like that your answer is not 100% correct. Might be out of 10, might be you will get 7, but still you will get 7.
Okay.
So this is my college life experience.
Okay. So miss, what we have understood is that obviously for every stammerer, whenever we are in the childhood phase, so we actually face a lot of problems due to stammering. Whether we whether whenever we have to talk with the teacher or with the friends or with the parents. So we actually stammer a lot and we face the block. So for every stammerer, I think that there are many stammerers who actually feel very much depressed while they go in these phases. So it's not like that you have to be very much depressed. Stammering problem is actually manageable. If you think to overcome it, then you can surely be overcoming it. And obviously we can see that here as my relative, that is, he actually told that whenever he faces some issues due to stammering, what he does, he doesn't think a negative about it. He actually thinks some actually positive things, how to overcome or how to handle that situation. So there are many ways which you can follow to overcome your stammering. So obviously, okay, so the next thing we just want to know from you is that since you have given many interviews in many platforms, IT industries, so Ms. tell us something about interview experience, that because for every stammerer it is a very fearful thing to go to the interview and just give the interview, because though we have the knowledge of the subject, but we feel the fear about not communicating in a good way. So Ms., what are the tips do you follow to just give the interview very nicely?
Okay, really, I was a technical guy and I was very much strong in technical. So if you will take online exam or if you will ask me to write something, it's not an issue for me, that I can do it easily. But when I have to face someone and I have to speak, then it was a nightmare. In the earlier days of my interview, it was a nightmare for me. I faced a lot of things and spent more than 2 years. I used to not get a job. After completing my engineering, I was got rejected by many of the companies due to this stammering only, because I was a fresher. I had the technical knowledge, but I was not able to crack the interview. So then I thought, how come I do it? And we are not, obviously we are not from an orthodox family, that we have a lot of money that we can enjoy and we can stay and we can spend 5 years, 6 years, then if I'll get a job, then it will be fruitful to our family. We are a middle class family, so we have to get the job anyhow and we have to earn as quickly as possible. Then I was very much depressed and I hardly had any friend. Only one friend was there. He was always there. And he was also not aware of my stammer, because I never opened up my stammering problem to him. I hardly used to talk. Basically, whenever is there is any stammerer, as I have seen that, they talk very less, because they are shy, because might be their stammering problem will be get noticed by someone, might be after knowing they will bullying, they'll make a fun of these guys. So all these things, I faced lot of hurdles in my life. Then one day I was simply sitting in my room and I was thinking that I have to crack it. But how come I crack it? Every time when I used to face the interview, my mind was that I have to crack it anyhow. And when I think about this one, then I got that my mind become got fear that I have to crack it. That means I'm, how come I overcome it? So then I got rejected many times. Then one day I thought, how to crack the interview, because every time I got rejected. Then I thought, okay, let it be. I faced a lot of things. So it was a 22 numbers, a 21 number, or it's a 10th or 5th, hardly it matter. Let's go face the interview and just think that they are not going to select me. Just think the negative, fully negative, that I am not going to selected by these guys. So let it be. If you can face the interview better, then it's okay, you will get selected. If not, then they are reject. So just think, before facing the interview, just think that one, that they are not going to select you. So once you feed this thing into your mind, then your mind will read this one only. You will not become fear by this thought. So just feed your mind, I am not going to select. Okay, let it be. go straight forward, whatever they will ask, say, speak, speak it. If you know, if you don't know, just say, okay, I don't know. Then, but before this, to bring some attitude, this attitude, this that, what is the attitude? Attitude will be that I am not going to select it. So be bold. This attitude should come. Once you have this attitude, then only you can crack, or I might be, it will take time, but to bring this sort of thinking into your mind, or to feed this one, that I am not going to select it. Just think, only this one, I am not going to select it. Okay. So just feed this one, hopefully, might be you will got overcome any interviews.
Okay. Right. Yeah. So we have actually learned a very important lesson in our life. The thing is that before going to interview, you should be prepared. If you are a technical guy, you should be strong in the technical things. After just 1 to 2 days before the interview, or just before the interview, the thoughts we have in our mind that yes, I have to get selected because I have studied this much, I have to be selected because I have done the coaching from that institute. It's not like that. Because whatever we think, it may not happen. So what we should do is that we shouldn't have that expectation level. So we are not saying that I will not get selected, so I will not study. It's not like that. You have to be technically strong. Everything that you have in your hand, you have to do that. You have to be strong in your field. After that, since we are a stammerer, we should be emotionally strong. How to be emotionally strong? We shouldn't think that, yes, I have to get selected, otherwise my life will be just destroyed, or I will not be able to do anything after this if I am not selected in this interview. It's not like that. Life is not just about an interview, right? So think in the mind, you shouldn't have that expectation level. And obviously for every stammerer, that overthinking is a very, very much issue. If you overthink in any circumstance, if you overthink, then obviously you will fail in the most cases. So don't think much. You have studied, you have prepared a lot, because before just 1 to 2 days of interview, you can't change it, right? So whatever preparation you have taken, it's enough. Just think in your mind that yes, it's no, it will not, if you are not selected, it's okay. I will just have another chance. But don't pressurize, don't take undue pressure in your mind, because we also stammer. What we do, we take undue pressure in our mind that if I stammer, what they will think, if I stammer, whether will I get selected or not. Don't take that undue pressure. If you don't have this undue pressure in your mind, then obviously you will be calm and bold, and you will be able to express your thoughts in a much better way. So this is the thing. Okay thank you. So obviously
Just I want to share one more thing. What is the difference between stammerer and non-stammerer? Those who are not stammerer, they used to study a lot, and they are always thinking that, okay, I have to crack this interview anyhow. And they also got pressurized, and they also try to do their best to crack the interview. But as we are a stammerer, my personal experience, I am not going into any debate and all. My personal experience that if you think, we have to think in the opposite way, because we are getting bullied, we are getting people used to make fun of us. So we have to think in a negative way. I think the negative way is one of the solution to get success, because we have to think, you prepare yourself for the technical interview or whatever the interview, and then think, I am not going to select it. But let's try my best. So try my best at two things. One is communication and one is technical. So two things are there. So try to make yourself strong in technical. And for the communication part, you think that I'm not going to get selected. Okay, but I'll try my best. Just feed this into your mind. Once your mind start to read that you are not going to selected, then you will not get any sort of fear while facing that guy. And that at that time might be you will not face a lot of stammering sort of things, and might be you will get cleared. There are a lot of cases are also there. I'm going to ask you, well, out of 100, might be 1 or 2% guys or interviewer are also there. They know, okay, this guy is having problem. So you have to not considering in the pity eyes, considering when, okay, he is having the problem, but he know. So we have to give him the chance. So in this way, we also get some success. be positive.
Right. Obviously. So whenever you are going to the interview, you just make in the mind that yes, it may be a positive experience, it may be a bad experience. So it's not that every time we are having bad or every time we are having good experiences. So you should have the flavor of every experiences. So just be flexible in your life. Don't be rigid that no, I have to select it, or I have to do this, or I have to do that. It's not like that. Everything doesn't happen within from our own will. We have to accept the things, because whenever you don't accept, you actually suffer a lot. If you try to accept, okay, I am stammerer. Yes, I am a stammerer. Yes, so what is the issue? There are many guys who are facing from this stammering problem, but they are doing very good things and very great things, right? Okay, so just coming to our next questions, and before that, for every new members of TISA, the Indian Stammering Association, I will request you to use the techniques, because the techniques are the most important tools that which will help you in order to overcome the blocks during your stammering. So we have the four techniques, that is the ba bouncing, the next is prolongation, the third is pausing. So these are the three techniques, and obviously the fourth technique is stammering. It is voluntary stammering. So obviously you have to just follow these four techniques, because it helps a lot. There are many guys in the TISA who have followed these techniques, and they are doing wonders and wonders, and yes, it will help you also. So just coming to the next question, because we stammerers have much fear in our mind. So since you are working in a big private firm, so it is obviously very important for an employee working in a private firm to have a very good communication skill. So whenever a stammerer come in this field, so they are thinking, they are actually fearing many things. They are actually fearing the interviews. So according to you, what are the tips do you want to give to a stammerer guy who are interested in coming to this big private firms, or miss, they should come or not? What do you think?
Not in case of interviews. For interview, my best way is the only thing that initially I used to think that I am not going to be selected, and make myself bold and try to fit this into my mind. One, my mind does not care about that I have to do good in the interview so that I got selected. So first I try to fit the negative things into my mind, and then in this way I am overcome this problem. I faced that interviewer make fun of us, but not in front of my face to face, but I can feel it. Sometimes they were not interested to listen to me because it's not a smooth line or streamline. So these are the things you will face. It's not like that it's easier. And as much as easy way I'm telling you, it's not easy, but it will take time, but you can do it. And in terms of while working, that place is also a challenging for us, because every time we used to talk in a conference call, we have to take that demonstration. Everything is there. So, this is the technique. I don't know what is called this technique. I don't know. This is my I have think about this one, and I maintain it. And I try to follow this one before demonstration also. I think, okay, let it be, I'll try, it's okay, it's good or whatever, better, but I'll try my best. If it's okay, and if I got scolded by my manager, since although I don't have anything to do. So first, every time I used to try to fit negative thing into my mind. And in the conference calls also, we have to take, so before, in the conference calls, you have a little bit of time, so to explain about the status and all. So try to be make it short and speak slowly. Don't in a hurry. Once you will be in a hurry, you will get stuck somewhere. And our, as a stammerer, we know that we want to finish it as quickly as possible. So that, okay, not like this. Try to make it slowly, try to speak slowly. So in this way, you can overcome all these things.
Okay. So obviously, what we have learned is that you don't take this stammering issue very seriously in your life. Whenever you take it seriously, then and there the problem starts. So don't feed your mind with undue pressure that what will happen or what. Don't think about the result. Just do your best. Whatever we are giving, whatever we have the techniques, follow that, because it actually helps in the difficult times when you face the stammering issue. So these are the things, and I hope you guys have enjoyed this interview very well, and obviously very, very thank you to you also for being the guest in this interview. So very, very thank you, and I also hope you have enjoyed a lot. So obviously thank you very much for everybody for seeing this video, and please give a thumbs up, and please like, comment and share the video as much as possible.